Came out here to Pine Creek. It's about the middle of May. And this is Jeremy's first time ever on Pine Creek, right?
Yep.
Just stopped at the fly shop. Picked up a couple tips from that guy at Big Meadows. And just got here to the creek. We're taking a look here. Not seeing much activity right now, so.
Throw some wet flies.
Maybe throw some wet flies here since nothing's rising on the surface. And maybe catch some fish. If not, oh well, still have a good time out here. Pretty nice scenery up here in the mountains, so should be a good afternoon. Jeremy's hooked up to his first fish of the day here on Pine Creek. Got him on the green woolly bugger.
Yep.
That's a nice fish.
Gonna tie her out.
Yep. Like we said, this is Jeremy's first time fishing Pine Creek, so this will be your first trout on Pine Creek.
Yep.
It's pretty sweet.
Yeah, man.
There he is. Nice rainbow.
Thank you.
First one of the day.
First rainbow of the day.
Hopefully we can get some more.
For sure.
What'd you catch him on, Grant?
I was drifting a soft tackle wet fly. It's basically like a March Brown imitation wet fly, so it's a pretty nice one too.
Oh yeah.
It's a pretty fat brown.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Look at that thing.
Right there he is. That's my first one of the day here on Pine Creek. Pretty good brown trout. Healthy looking fish. So we'll get him back released and keep fishing. We got several hours to fish here this afternoon, so hopefully we can land a bunch more.
So this happened the first cast after Grant just caught his. So we're getting hot here.
Yeah, these fish are starting to eat. Are you still using that woolly bugger?
Woolly bugger. I had to switch woolly buggers because I think I lost one.
That other fish took yours.
Yeah. Still green woolly bugger though. They're hitting that pretty well today.
I'm gonna try and just grab them.
Yep. Yep, grabbing pretty good. There you go. So that's your second one landed of the day. You've missed a couple others, right?
Yeah, missed one.
Got him right in the lip with that green woolly bugger. Pulled him up there a little bit. Good looking rainbow. Let's get him back and get another one.
Absolutely.
I caught a fish. Jeremy's next cast after filming me, he caught a fish. My next cast after filming Jeremy, I hooked this one.
Three straight casts. Another one on the board.
There he is. That one's a little bit smaller, and this is a rainbow. Just a little 12-incher, probably. Took the same wet fly that I was using for that first fish.
Quick release.
All right, so I just wanted to show you guys the wet fly that I used to catch those trout. Can't see it real well now because it's wet, but that's what they're taking right now. And
literally as we've been catching these few fish on wet flies, more and more fish are starting to rise. So at some point we could get to the point here where we might want to start fishing something on the surface. This is the time of year on Pine Creek where in about the middle of May, and great time for March browns. There's another fishish rose. There's also gray foxes, blue-winged olives, caddis. There's a lot of food right now for the fish. So a lot of times that can make it actually tough to figure out what the fish want to eat, especially when they're eating on the surface. They can be very picky, but it can also make it very good fishing. So hopefully we'll have a good afternoon here the rest of the day.
Went to the first spot. Water's a little too deep. We had a little bit of rain last night. Not too much. So back where we were yesterday, Pine Creek. Probably gonna start out throwing some wet flies, see what we can do.
So second day in a row on Pine Creek, and we've been here for maybe a half hour. I missed a fish on a wet fly, and then we started to have probably three or four fish rise. Not all the fish are rising, but we had a few feeding on the surface. We tried a Griffith Gnat for Jeremy. That didn't work. I tried a blue-winged olive, and the first cast that I put in front of this fish, he nailed it. So there he is. Pretty average sized rainbow on the blue-winged olive. So we'll get him back and see if we can't get some of these other ones over here that are feeding. Can you see the blue-winged olive there? There's the blue-winged olive that I caught him on. Pretty small one. Not sure exactly what size it is, but there's more fish feeding as we're speaking.
Yep,
so
got some good action. Get him back. Fish jumping.
BWO, baby.
Jeremy's first fish on a dry fly right here. He tied on the blue-winged olive. Fish nailed it.
I'd casted it, floated it by. He came up like a foot away, like three different times.
Yeah.
Finally, just had enough.
You put it right over him, and he couldn't resist it.
Right in the wheelhouse.
Good little guy here.
It's a brookie.
Little brookie.
Nice little brook trout. Did he come off? Oh well. That's sweet though.
Didn't touch him.
I guess technically.
That does not count.
For POU, fish. That does not count as a landed fish. I mean, that's about as close as you can get. You can count, you can tell your family that counts as a catch though.
No,
but
no, I can't.
Within POU, that doesn't count as a land.
All right, BWO again, baby.
That's brook trout.
Man, a little bit so they didn't get off.
Yep.
All right, blue and olives are working.
But
came
you
off again. I touched it. That one counts.
So that one counts as a land.
That counts as a land for POU. So, yep. All right.
Fun fact: blue winged olive is my new favorite fly.
Yeah, because it's the first, probably the first dry fly you've ever used, and you're here. You are with your third fish. This one lost him. That one was a nicer one too. Right.
That was the nice one I've caught so far.
Yeah. Looked like a pretty nice brown.
All right, so that's the end of our weekend fishing trip on Pine Creek for me and Jeremy. We're heading home tonight, and we had a pretty fun weekend. We didn't catch a whole bunch of fish, but we caught enough to have a lot of fun, and got to get Jeremy his first fish on dry flies today, so that was a lot of fun. And the good thing is that we still have a lot of fishing left to do this spring, so we can't wait to be back.